Hey guys, this is Amy with Ask Amy with Gold Plating Services. I'm with our plating specialist, Terry, again, and he is going to go over plating onto a nickel piece, nickel plating onto a copper piece. Terry?
Okay, hi Amy. Hi everybody. We've got a client who has been using their JewelMaster successfully for some time, plating gold onto small items, and they had a question if they could use the JewelMaster for plating with nickel onto copper or stainless steel items. And the answer is yes, absolutely we can. We have to make a couple of little changes in the setup, and there's a few things we have to know about nickel, and I'll go over that. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show how we're set up, and I'm going to demonstrate nickel plating onto some copper pieces. Now, the one thing you need to remember about nickel is that nickel takes about five times the amount of area or power per area for the area that you're plating. And so you're going to be somewhat limited to how big of pieces you can use that you can plate with the JewelMaster. I've always told people that have asked in the past, I've said if you want to do a lot of pieces, or if you want to do production plating, they're very large pieces, then it would be better for you to have us help you set up a larger plating bath, maybe a 1 gallon or even up to a 5 gallon nickel bath, just for convenience. However, for small applications, the JewelMaster is perfect. And what I'm going to do is to demonstrate it is I've got these little copper elbows that we just picked up at the hardware store, and they're half inch copper. And what I did was just did a very quick buffing on them to kind of knock off the heavy oxidation on the outside. I didn't go through a fine polishing process. You can see there's a lot of scratches and blemishes left, but I just wanted to kind of brighten up the surface. I'll talk more about the nickel plating process while the part is in the nickel. We'll have a couple of minutes then. To set up the JewelMaster, what I've done is I've set it up in a typical fashion with the electroclean in the left position, the surface activator in the middle position, and the nickel plate in the plating position where the gold solution may go. Now, this has been in there for a little while, and we've got the heater on full, and right now the temperature is about 138 degrees, and that's plenty warm. In fact, that's kind of the 140 is the upper range, and 120 to 140 is the old, the optimum range for the solution. I've set up as usual with our three rinse beakers with distilled water in each of them. To plate this piece, I'm just going to take a little piece of wire that I've fashioned into a rack. We'll hang the copper elbow on the wire, and we'll just begin by putting it into the electroclean. And you can see you get the normal gassing that you would typically would get. And we're going to do this for probably about 30 seconds. One of the things that's kind of funny about nickel is that it really likes to have a very clean surface. And so when we've taken this out of the electroclean and after we've activated it, I'm going to look at the surface and make certain that I don't get any water breaks or any water beading or anywhere on the surface where the water behaves differently, because that would it almost certainly would be a problem with the nickel plating. I think that's been about right. We'll dump that out. We'll go into our rinse here. And we can kind of take a look at it now and see that the water is sheeting off evenly. There's really no water breaks. Now we'll go into our activator solution. We'll hang it, and again, I'm going to go for probably 20 to 30 seconds. And this activation is just something to make certain that we have good adhesion and that the nickel will adhere well. Now, I probably could have built the rack so that I could plate two of these at a time. However, that probably would be the upper limit for how much you'd want to be able to play. That'd be about 12 square inches of nickel of area. These are about 6 inches apiece, 6 square inches of area. Now, as with the gold, I'm going to go into my my plating solution rinse water first, just so I don't drag any part or any contaminated water back into my plating bath. Now we're going to put it onto the bus. And if you can look, we're running about 4 volts, and it's about 2.8, 2.9 amperes of current. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to plate this for, just for the sake of the length of the video, I'm going to plate for 1 minute on this side. Then I'm going to take the part out and rotate it around and plate it for 1 minute on the other side so that both halves of the part have equal exposure to the anode. Nickel is kind of funny in that it really likes to deposit in a line of sight with the anode. That's very much favored. So in the amount of time that we're plating these, the inside of these tubes probably won't plate very much. One nice thing about nickel is that you can, now, oh, by the way, when we set up, I wanted to bring this out. We had to set up with the bagged nickel anode. And the anode is a pure nickel anode that's in a cloth bag. And the reason we have to have it in a bag is because as we plate the nickel out of the solution, the anode will actually corrode or dissolve, if you will, and replace the nickel in the solution. And as that happens, there are little granular particles that if you don't catch them in a bag, they can deposit onto the surface and make a rough nickel deposit. Well, I haven't kept really good track of the time, but I'm just going to say it's probably time to turn it over. And as you can see, we've got a nice contiguous layer of nickel that is on there. Now, there's a lot of reasons for doing nickel plating on to copper or other reactive metals, and that is that nickel can act as what we call a diffusion barrier that will keep the copper from eventually seeping through the gold plate. If we were to gold plate these with a very thin gold without any nickel, then over time, and particularly in a corrosive environment like the sea air or in a moist environment or a very hot environment, the copper will eventually, we call it diffusion, it works its way through and it can appear as a little bit of darkening or corroding of the gold. And really it's not the gold changing at all, it's the copper coming through the gold. And so nickel is a very common and excellent diffusion barrier. In fact, I think that's why the client that I'm talking about wants to apply the nickel to serve as a diffusion barrier. So
we're at a minute.
Okay, so we'll go ahead and pull that out. And I just, now the other thing about nickel is that we could continue to plate, and if we plate longer, the nickel will actually become more bright. However, the nickel works the very best if you can provide some type of agitation. And so if you wanted to plate this for maybe 5 or 10 minutes and develop a really super bright, shiny surface, then you either would want to provide air agitation with this, with a JewelMaster, or optimally you would want to maybe have a larger plating set up with on a hot plate stirrer, where you can have continuous agitation, and then you could just hang the part in there. Anyway, let's take a look and see how we did. And so you can see the nickel is fairly nice and bright. And that's really the bolts and nuts of nickel plating with the JewelMaster.
Great. Can I see it next to the copper one, just so I can have a contrast of the two?
Yeah, let's see how it turns out.
Great, Terry. Now, are there any other tips, possibly, that as we're plating or as we're going into the nickel solution, that would be maybe a red flag that it's not plating properly, or
Yeah, you know, one thing that I would encourage anybody to watch for is that when they come out of the electroclinum, before they go into the nickel, in fact, if I dip this part into our rinse water without electroclinum, I don't know if we can see that or not, but you can get water breaks. And the water's sheeting off fairly good. Let's go into the activator just for a second. And then we'll come out. See how right here you can see there's a bead of water and the kind of a dry area around it. See how the water kind of pulls away?
Yeah.
I don't know if you can see that with the camera or not, but you're probably, if you were to just put that into the nickel right now without the electrocleaning, that probably would be a problem in your nickel plate. And so if I saw that, then what I would do is, and that's why we want to inspect it carefully now, I would want to go back into the electrocleaner, maybe even two or three times, and for another 30 seconds, I won't do it right now, but then pull it out and rinse. And just make sure that the part totally wets out. And so this inspection to make certain that the surface wets out before you go into the nickel is critical. Because if you plate, see here you can see there's no beading whatsoever after just that little teeny bit of electrocleaning I did. And so, you know, you would be safer going into the nickel solution. But that's probably the most important thing is to make sure that you inspect carefully after the electrocleaning to make sure the surface wets out.
Okay, just one last quick question. Can you burn the nickel like we can burn gold if our voltage is too high?
You can. You can have an over voltage. In fact, maybe with this piece, we could just sacrifice it and we could, I don't know if, you can put it in here and I'll increase the voltage up to, let's go clear up as high as 5 volts. And we'll just leave it for maybe 15 or 20 seconds and see if we get burning. If we do get burning, it'll probably be along the edges or the sharp edge or the corner, the point of the rack, and it would show up as a dark deposit. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're getting burning there now. But the other thing that you can get with an overvoltage condition is the nickel can deposit much more rapidly on the edge or the corner than it does in the field. And so you could actually, in time, get distortion of the geometry of the part. I've seen that happen, where like on a tube, it'll build up really thick around the edge of the tube and the tube might not slide into a connector after nickel plating. And the nickel can plate thick. It plates, it's 100 micro inches or 2.5 microns in 3 or 4 minutes. And so here we are at a higher voltage. And so higher voltage means we've got much higher current density. And I don't think we've got any burning at all. So as you can see, the nickel is fairly tolerant. And like with most plating operations, what I do is I encourage people to plate at as high a voltage as they can get away with without having burning. And then they can get the fastest deposition rate and the best throughput. However, with nickel, you want to be really careful because if you do get burning, it's not as easy to repair as it is with gold because nickel is much harder than gold. So, you know, if you got into a deal where you let parts burn, you know, buffing them out is a lot different than just cleaning up a little bit of burned gold with baking soda and water.
All right.
But it's pretty tolerant, so we're at 5 volts, and we're actually running the current is about 4 amperes of current. So it's, you know, on this small of a piece, that much difference is pretty significant, and the part still turned out well. It looks. very much like the other one we did.
All right. Well, thank you, Terry, for taking a few minutes of your time to show us how to nickel plate onto our copper tubes. Any other questions, guys, that you may have, feel free to give us a call.
One more thing I wanted to add, if you haven't stopped.
No, you're good.
If we were going to do a stainless steel item, I would set up with exactly the same setup. I would do everything exactly the same, with the exception of the middle beaker would have Woods Nickel Strike or Acid Gold Strike. And if you have Woods Nickel Strike in the middle beaker, you would also need a bag nickel anode in your activator solution. If you use an Acid Gold Strike, then you would need to use a platinized anode in the middle beaker.
Okay, so. Great. Thank you so much, Terry. We'll see you guys soon.